ओके चिल्ड्रन, सो दिस इज हाउ एक्सटेम्पोर केम इनटू बीइंग एंड जैम इज वन ऑफ द गेम्स विच स्कूल्स आर वेरी पॉपुलर. इट्स अ वेरी पॉपुलर गेम इन स्कूल्स एंड टीवी शोज. एंड व्हाट डू दे डू? दे मेक यू स्पीक. एंड हाउ डू दे मेक यू स्पीक? वेल, लेट अस लुक एट द रूल्स ऑफ दिस स्पीकिंग एक्सरसाइज. वेल, व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इज यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर अ वेरी शॉर्ट स्पीच एंड यू आर गिवन अ प्रेपरेशन टाइम ऑफ वेरी वेरी लिमिटेड amount. So let's say it's about 15 to 20 seconds that you get to prepare your speech and 1 or 2 minutes where you get to speak about it. So what is the structure? It's purely about thinking on your toes, and you have to continuously speak for 1 minute or even more. And the whole idea is to see how confidently you speak. What is the focus of your speech? So, for example, the topic is my school. You cannot speak about institutions and studies in outside India or something which is not pertaining to school. So you cannot deviate from the topic. And also, third and most importantly, you cannot repeat your points. So these three things are very, very important. This is the first thing that you are judged on. The focus of the topic you're judged on, and no repetition. And lastly, but not the least, is your big smile that you always have to have. You have to wear your big smile and come to the stage. So this is what an extempore is. Now let us try to create an extempore together, okay? It's a very simple and a very, very easy exercise if you know the tricks. So what are the... what is the mantra? It's the three C's. What do I call them? I call them the three C's. And what are those three C's? Your confidence when you're speaking, and it should come in your way you speak and the way you stand, the content, what you're speaking about, and the connect. And how do you make that connect? You make it with that big, broad smile that you bring to your face. Okay? So let's get started. Now, the first and the foremost thing is to understand what is the format, what is the flow of speaking. How do you start your speech? Any speech that you start, it has to start with a greeting. So the audience which is present, they should feel part of your speech. They should feel that you're talking to them. So how do you do that? You have a salutation. Yes, the greetings for them. So you can say a good morning. You can also use a quote to say hello, and you can start with stating the topic. So for example, if I am talking about a school, I will say, good morning, everyone. The topic of today's speech is the school. And then you introduce the topic. You give your opinion about the topic and how would you define the topic? What do you think a school is? The next part is the body of the speech. The body of, not your body, but the body of the speech. And you should have at least 3 points to talk about. So you can talk about your school. What is the name of your school? The kind of school it is. You can also talk about the advantages of going to a school. You can talk about the teachers, the administration, the system, whatever you want and whatever comes to your mind. But it should be at least 3 points. And lastly is your conclusion, where you have to give one punchline which will get the audience rocked. They'll say, oh my God, this girl or this boy has done a fantastic job. So you end your speech with a bang. So they forget this disappears. But what really remains with the audience is this and this. So always strike a balance with your speech and your smile and your confidence. Okay, so let's get started. All right, now let's take the topic for today's extempore as my dream home. Okay, so now what you have to do is nothing much. Close your eyes for a second, take a long deep breath and think about a house which is your dream house. Okay, just think about it. What kind of a house would you like to live in? Great. I see everybody closing their eyes. Fantastic. All right. Vanya, the topic is my dream home. Okay. Now, to help you a little, open your eyes. I'll show you two pictures. Okay, picture one and picture two. Now, you decide which house would you like to live in. Would you like to pick house number one, which is like a huge villa, or house number two, which is like a remote, cozy, hill station-like dwelling? All right, most of you want one. Okay. Now, what I want you to do is, I give you about 10 seconds, quickly jot down all the words that you'll use to describe this dream house of yours. 10 seconds. And the time starts now. Tick, tick one, tick, tick two, tick, tick three, tick, tick four, tick, tick five, tick, tick six, tick, tick seven, eight again, nine, oops, seven again, eight, nine, 10. There it stops. Stop. Stop and stop. No writing anymore. Thank you. Very good, Mehal. Very good. Okay, Sparsh. Wow, nice words you've got to describe it. Okay, I can help you a little more. All right. What I'll do is, now, whichever is your dream house, I'm going to show you some words. All you have to do is just add to your list. Okay? Luxurious. Which one do you think it is? One or two? Superb, it's one. Comfortable. Expensive, which is this? Primitive. Which one is primitive? What is primitive? Primitive is very old, okay? Yes. Modern? High maintenance. What does high maintenance mean? Where you have to put a lot of money to maintain it. Rural. Rural? Rural will be? Yes, it'll be two. Very good. Sparsh. Stylish. Very good. Affordable. Which one is affordable, Tanvita? Yes, super. You can show me your fingers and tell me one and two. Plain. Sai Vignesh, tell me, plane is one or two? Yes, okay, plane. Okay, close to nature, money? Close to nature, Diya? Okay, spacious? Very good, children, Miguel, very good. Urban, Anik, ornate? What is ornate? Ornate is super decorated. Something which is very highly decorated. Very good. Humble? Humble is very simple. Okay, yes. Shiva, very good. And peaceful? Very good, Mehal. Very, very good, children. Now, count how many words do you have to describe your dream home. Did you get enough words? About 10, 15? Yes? All right. Let's move ahead. Fantastic. Okay, now let's move to step number three. Now, there are three questions that you need to ask now yourself, okay? Now you have so many words with you. Now you will have to put them in different buckets. Now let's identify the buckets, okay? Now here there are so many subtopics about my dream home. Which are the three most important subtopics which you should cover in your speech? Tell me. Is the first one important? All right, Tanvita, very good. All right. Is the second one that important? Nirvi, is it important? No, very good. Okay, Kriti, very good. All right. What about ownership? Is it important? No, it is not. Very good. What is my idea of a house? Is this question important? Yes. Size and space? Asia? Important? Not important. Yes. Okay, but it is all covered in features of the dream house. All right. So, which means that there are three important questions which we need to answer, and they are definition, what is my idea of a house, and features of the dream house. And exactly these three questions you will use to frame your extempore. Now, let's see how we'll do it. The first question is definition of a dream home. Now, pick up three sentences and write them down about what do you think a dream home is. And you can use the words from the list that you have created. Come on, three sentences. And you don't have to write complete sentences, you just write points. Okay, to help you a little, I'll give you some points here. You just pick the key words and put it as your points. Don't write complete sentences. Very good, Syed. Very good. Comfortable, peaceful, beautiful, spacious. Very good. Okay, great, Mehul. All right. Now let's move to the second question. The second question is, what is my idea of a dream home? How should my dream home look like? Okay, now pick up three more points which are different from the first three points. Okay? Okay, Ashit, like a flat. Very good. Okay, Kishore. Watery, Trinav. What is watery? You mean surrounded by water? Okay, Kishore, independent house. Very good. Very good, Vihan. A plateau? Okay, here. I give you some more ideas. But no repetition. Remember, the first question, 3 points, should not be repeated in the second question. All right, now let's move to the third one. Now it is about the features of your house. First, we were doing a broad description. So, here this was a broad description. A place to bond, comfortable, luxurious, all of that. Now we go to the specific features of your house. So, what all will you look at? You look at the location. Where do you want it? A hill station or a village? Or outskirts of the city, whatever. The type of house, a flat or a villa or a bungalow, and all the facilities that it should have, amenities. Okay? I'll give you some help and you can also pick and choose at least 3 points. Only that apply to your house. Great. Hill station. Kinisha wants to stay in a hill station. Very good. On top of the hill, Vivan. Wow. All right. I wish I had the luxuries like Tanvita is thinking of. Swimming pool, etc. AI also. Artificial intelligence. Wow. All right, children. So now we are ready with our points. We have segregated it. Now let's come to the conclusion. Pick up one quote from here or any other quote that you know of about your house, and this will come as a conclusion. Pick up a very interesting one, okay? Something which you remember and something which you can also speak without hesitation. Okay. A sweet home, very good. All right. You can use your own quotation as well. You can frame yours. Home is where our heart is. Okay, Aditya. All right. So now we've fairly done the broad part of our work. You know what? You're almost on the verge of creating an extempore. Now what you have to do is just quickly structure it the way it should be. You should know it has to begin with a salutation. It has to have an introduction like the one which we did. It should have a body and it should have a conclusion. And what do you have to do? You have to use an effective introduction. So you can start by defining your house. And then you have to give the description of your house, the features that you want. And finally, you will do a conclusion with a very good punchline. And all this has to be remembered with a broad smile. So I give you a few seconds, say about 15 seconds, to quickly put your points in order. And then I will decide who's going to speak. Are you ready, children? All right, great. Sai Arun is ready already. Okay, please put your thumbs up if you're ready. Super. All right, Ashia is ready. Saniksha is ready. Very good. I've got a super brainy group. All right, then I'll have to. Okay, so but before we do that, let's look at a sample speech. Would you like a sample speech? Yeah? Would you like a sample speech? Well, we'll do the sample speech, but before that, let's do a self-check. It's not just about putting your points. It's also about checking it yourself. So there are some checkpoints. First is, did you put it in order? Yes or no? If you have, put your thumbs up. So it should be introduction, body, conclusion. Okay? And all in points, no sentences. Now let's look at the variety check. Do you have enough words so that you don't repeat it? Great. Let's look at deviation check. Are we only talking about my dream house? Hope we are not talking about anything else. So we are not talking about the people in the house, describing your mommy, daddy, describing your siblings, describing your pet dog. No. You are just describing your house. Now, repetition check. Hope you're not repeating any points. Okay. And are you wearing your smile? Are you wearing your smile? Yes or no? I can't see everybody smiling. I want a very broad smile. Fantastic. And a body language check. A body language check is when you stand like this, straight with your chin up and your back bilkul straight, absolutely straight. Okay? And you have to sit on the chair like that and wear that long smile which I told you about. Great. Now I'm going to do a sample speech for you. Hear the speech and then we are going to begin with one of you talking about my dream house. Okay?
The topic for today's discussion is my dream house. House is a place where we live with our family in full security and safety. It is a place of fun and bonding. I dream of having a house which is huge and palatial. It should have all the amenities of the world. I wish for a really luxurious dwelling with all comforts. But yes, I'm fed up with the humdrum of cities. I would like a very quiet suburban area to reside, all away from pollution and the trafficular disturbances of today's time. I could even look for a rural house because, you know, the greenery, the cattle, the fresh air, it all attracts me. While a house is just a building, it's the people who make it worth living. To me, a dream home will be a place where I live with my loved ones in all harmony and joy. Well, but a dream is a dream till it becomes a reality. Hope my wish comes true and I have a happy, peaceful, happy, luxurious house one day.